Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Glenn Hall Taylor's tale of a watery grave floating down the river. Starring Greg Morris. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company. Also by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, Shenley Industries, Matus Wine, and International Harvester. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Captain Patra Salonica, skipper of the river barge St. Christopher, emerges from the tiny cabin near the stern of the craft and gazes at the mist settling on the water. For a moment, Captain Salonica is wrapped in thought. Suddenly, the sound of splashing reaches his ears, and he turns to look toward the rail of the barge. A man is pulling himself from the water and climbing aboard.
Hey, who are you? I said, who are you?
Don't blow your cool. Give me a chance to get my breath.
What are you doing on my boat? Where do you come from?
Oh, what do you think?
What were you doing in the river at night?
I work on the tug. I fell overboard.
All right, here. Hey, take my hand. I help you get up.
Thanks.
What's the matter? You hurt?
My arm.
Yeah, it's bleeding. Here, come, we go to cabin. I take care of your arm. Get you some dry clothes, too. Come on. Here we are. Maria!
What you want?
We have here man fell off talk, need help.
Oh, what happened to his arm?
I'll be okay, miss.
Maria, fix the pillows. Here, mister. We put you on this bunk. Easy. Yeah. I go ashore. I get doctor for you.
No. Oh.
You need doctor.
I don't want no doctor.
Well, I tell you what. Maybe some whiskey help you.
That'd be fine.
Yeah, I have some forward. I get the bottle.
That arm hurt much?
I don't want no doctor. Tell your father that.
He ain't my father.
No?
He's my husband. Why don't you want a doctor?
I just don't, that's all. I'll straighten myself out in a little while. Let me stay here, huh?
You want to stay here?
Yeah.
I'll fix it so he don't get a doctor.
Hi, I'm Harry Dallas, Detective Homicide.
Yeah, glad to know you. I'm Dean Rockford. River Patrol. We're looking for a truckload of booze, but the grappling hooks haven't latched on anything yet.
I know what you were looking for.
Huh?
Yeah. My partner and I, he's still over there in an unmarked car listening to the radio. Chased the truck down here.
Wait a minute. Fill me in. How did it start?
Well, Robbery and Bunko got a tip about a plot to hijack this load of whiskey at a warehouse a few miles from here.
Huh.
We were cruising there when we got this code on the radio, so we rolled on it. Arrived just in time to see the truck barreling out of the place. We tailed it along the river road down here. The driver must have panicked because he turned off the road onto the dock and just kept going. Sailed right off the end.
Was the driver still in the truck?
Well, we know he didn't jump. We got on the mic right away and reported to headquarters.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah. There were two guys in on the job. There was some shooting. A watchman got killed. One of the hijackers took a slug in the chest. The ambulance took him to county emergency. Second guy got creased, so if he got it too bad, he might not have made it out of that cab.
Did you talk with the guy before they took him to the hospital?
No. He's out colder than yesterday's meatloaf. How long do you think it'll take to retrieve the truck?
Can't make a guess yet. Probably take until morning.
Figure. Well, I think we'll wheel over to county hospital and see if the wounded guy is able to talk yet. Be sure we're kept posted.
Right, we'll do.
So long, Rock.
See you soon. By the way, as long as we're going to be working together on this, I think it'd be quicker if you just call me Dean.
Right. In case you didn't catch it, Harry's my first name. See you, Dean.
Good morning. Finally woke up, huh?
Hi.
Sleep good?
What time is it?
Nearly 10. Like some coffee?
Sounds fine. Where's your husband?
On deck, working. Coffee's all made. I'll pour you some.
Your name's Mary, ain't it?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Heard him call you that last night.
Here you are. Oh, careful. It's hot.
Much obliged. My name's Al.
Well, I guess we're introduced. I done like he asked me, Al. Talked him out of going for a doctor.
I kind of thought you would, baby.
I told him you felt a lot better.
I wish I did. Especially now that you and me... That arm hurts.
I went ashore this morning. I had to do some shopping. The checker at the supermarket told me that last night a truck went off the dock about a quarter of a mile up the river. Some guy was in it. The truck was stolen.
No kidding. Was the guy drowned?
At first they thought he was. But when they got the truck out, there wasn't nobody in it. Now they ain't sure.
What do they think happened to him?
I don't know, but I think he got away. I didn't say nothing to my husband about it.
Why?
It might get the guy in trouble.
Why are you putting yourself on his team?
Because it takes guts to do what he did.
You like that, huh?
I think it's super.
And I think you are, kid. Tell me something. How come you married an old seagull like the skipper?
I don't know. I expect it was because he was nice to me. He treated me like a lady. Not like just another broad.
Oh, you could have done better than him with what you got. Or maybe that's what you wanted.
You out of your gourd. I hate living on this dirty scow. Go no place, see nothing, do nothing. I ain't old like him. I want to swing.
Maybe that could be arranged.
How?
Tell you what, babe, I'll make you a deal. You fix it with that old guy so as I can lay low on this tub for a while. And when it's time I should split, you pack your duds and come with me.
I was hoping you'd say that. Would you kiss me, Al? Well, that was mighty good, lover boy.
If you think that was good, babe, wait till I can grab you with both arms.
Good morning, Harry.
Morning, Dean. Report came in, huh?
Yeah, just before I telephoned you. Pull up that chair, we'll go over.
What's the scoop?
Well, as you know, we finally pulled the truck up.
Yeah, how about the driver?
And the door next to the driver's seat was open. Now, of course, he still could have been drowned, but they've been dragging the river for the body. And what did you find out?
Well, his pal in the hospital finked on him just a little while ago. Driver's name's Al Morgan.
Yeah, that name rings a bell.
Yeah, robbery and bunco sent him up a few years ago. He's a rough one.
Any leads on where he lives or any places he hangs out?
Not yet, but we're checking.
I played a hunch early this morning. It didn't work out, though.
What was that?
There's several barges tied up downriver. I figured that if he was still alive, he might have holed up on one of them, so I checked them all, but none of the captains could give me anything.
Morgan's pal told me he was shot in the arm. They could have handicapped him, so maybe he didn't survive. Mm-hmm. Or maybe he made it and still hiding out someplace ashore. None of us liked that short sentence he pulled last time. This time it's murder. If we can grab him, maybe we can put him in a slam for keeps.
Maria?
Shh. He's sleeping.
Still?
He woke up once and had coffee. He's real pooped.
Well, I want to speak with him about something.
What is it, Patrick?
He's very important. He must tell me something.
I wasn't sleeping. What's so important?
A river patrol officer stopped by a little while ago. He was looking for a man who drove a stolen truck into the river last night.
Now, look, Patrick.
You be quiet, Maria. I did not tell the officer about this man yet, but I would like to ask him some questions.
Like what, mister?
Well, I would like you to tell me the name of the tug on which you worked. The one you say you fell off.
If you gotta know, it was the Queen Mary.
Don't be funny with me, young man. I have been what you might call a good sport, but I am captain here. I have good reputation. I cannot afford to do things against the law.
So?
So I think you are the man the officer is looking for.
And if I am?
Then I turn you in.
I'll level with you, Pop. I'm the guy, but you ain't turning me in.
He stayed here,
Mattress. I always give you good advice. I try to make you know what is right and wrong. Do not do this.
I say he stays here.
But, Maria, this man is bad. He's a dangerous criminal. Why you take his side in this? You, my wife.
Why do you think?
Kind of looks like I stay, don't it, Pop?
You mean you and my wife? Well, you don't do this to Captain Salonika. Out of my way, mister. I go get police right now.
I wouldn't do that if I was you.
You don't stop me.
Look out for his dead arms.
I still got a good one left, baby.
Oh, do you think knocking him out is enough?
Do you?
No.
Baby, you and me are going to get along just great. Open the door. I'm going to drag him out on deck.
Dean Rockford.
Dean, Harry Dallas. I'm calling about the body your crew picked out of the river just after dawn this morning.
You been to the morgue?
Mm-hmm. It's not Al Morgan. It's the body of a barge captain.
Murder?
We suspect it. No knife or bullet wounds on the body and no signs of strangling or blunt instrument work.
You think someone, maybe Morgan, might have killed him?
It's possible. He might have gotten rid of him so he could use the barge as a hideout.
Any identification on him?
None. Why don't you go over to the morgue and see if you can recognize it?
Right. I'll get on it right away.
Homicide, Dallas speaking.
Harry, Dean Rockford. Listen, I'm calling from the morgue.
Recognize the guy?
Yeah, he's one of the barge captains I questioned, all right. The only problem is I don't remember his name or which barge he was on. But I'm going to check it out.
How?
Well, I'll have to do it the hard way. By boarding every one of those barges until I can find the right one.
Morning, Miss,
Salonika. And it's Mrs., not Miss. What's the River Patrol want on board the St. Christopher?
Oh, just routine, Mrs. Salonika. I'm Officer Rockford. I'm checking all the barges along here. The body was taken from the river today. The man happened to be a barge captain. Is your skipper aboard?
No. My husband, he's the captain, went ashore about 10 minutes ago.
Well, I'm glad to hear that he's okay. One of the other barge captains told me the description I gave might fit your husband.
You know something? Captain Whitaker, two barges down the river, is sometimes mistaken for my husband. How would you describe the man you're looking for?
Oh, about 55, gray hair, 5'6" maybe. I guess it'd be weighed around 160.
It could fit Captain Whitaker. I'd try if I were you.
Second dock down, you said?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. I'll get right down there.
The fuzz gone?
Yeah. You heard, huh?
I heard, baby. You handled it real good.
But that don't mean he won't be back. What can we do?
Well, I told you. I'd take you away from this tub so we could do some swinging together. Now I can keep my word.
When do we go?
Right now, baby. Right now.
So you think this might be the payoff?
Could be. I could kick myself for letting that woman con me.
How'd she con you?
She told me this Captain Whitaker looks like her husband. So I went to see him. The minute I got aboard, I knew I'd been had. Whitaker looks nothing like Salonika. For my money, she's had something to do with her husband getting that permanent dunking.
We'll soon find out. There's the St. Christopher. Pull over there on that dock.
There's nobody aboard this tub.
Doesn't seem to be. But let's not take any chances. Stand back while I open the cabin door.
No one in there.
Let's take a look around. See what's in those drawers.
Yeah, man's clothes. Only a few woman's things.
Probably made a run for it. How about that locker?
same here. Man's coats and pants at this end. Empty hangers at the opposite end. It should be where her things have been hanging. How about that wastebasket? Anything there?
Oh, just a bunch of papers and a... Uh-oh. Your hunch was probably right. Al Morgan could have been here. Look, a bloody bandage.
Yeah, we're getting warm. I'll wrap the bandage in a towel and take it along.
Here's an envelope addressed to Mrs. Salonika. According to this, she gets her mail in care of general delivery at the main post office. I'm going to save this envelope. Might give us a lead.
Save the stamps. They're genuine antiques. 11-cent airmails.
Let's get back to the car. I want a radio for an APB on Mrs. Salonika and Al Morgan. Then, just for insurance, you and I are going to stake out that general delivery window for the next few days.
I wonder who that is.
Hush, I know.
Hey, Dolly, who's this? Charlie! Yo, so-and-so. Come on, I want to buy a drink.
Yeah, let's get the party going.
That's a couple of drunks.
Hey, Charlie!
Well, get rid of them, will you?
Okay, okay. Shut up, you guys. What do you think you're doing?
Police. Thanks for opening up. Saves a lot of trouble. Come on, face the wall.
You too, sister.
What's the big idea?
The big idea is murder, Mrs. Salonika. We've got witnesses who saw your friend Al Morgan kill the watchman at the warehouse. And with your help, we're going to tie him into the death of your husband.
How did you know where we were?
We followed you from the post office. Which reminds me, Mrs. Salonika, you're going to have a change of address card.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Loading Down the River is an original radio drama adapted by Glenn Hall Taylor. Greg Morris was heard as Harry Dallas. Featured in the cast were Dick Ryan, Jack Crucian, Ginny Tyler, and Jerry Dexter. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Coates, directed by Don Hughes, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.